And the other bounce. Yeah, those rounds are doesn't happen often.
Mikey, this is week four for you back in the gym. Week four. You're looking slimmer and slimmer every time I see you. It's coming off. Don't tell people.
I'm losing weight.
Charles, is he losing weight?
I'm not worried about that right now. What about getting
But it's good. If you're in the gym, it means that something big might happen.
Means that he wants to help Jose Ramirez get ready. That's what he's saying.
That's true. I like that fight. You know, Jose. You guys make a bet about the fights or something?
Come back. At least watch this today, man.
Josh Teller and Jose Ramirez, they'll entertain because we talk about taller guys, longer, but you know, Taylor doesn't fight long. Taylor fights on the inside. Taylor fights short, close fights. He's more than what if I program you see that? That's gonna make for a very, very entertaining, great fight. You know,
I agree.
It's gonna be
fireworks.
That's probably a. It's probably gonna come down to who has the most will. You know,
it's gonna be a great fight.
Those guys are gonna fight. They're gonna.
I got Jose, but
of course I see. When it comes down to a battle of will. And intestinal fortitude, there's nobody in the world that will beat Jose in that part of it.
Do you think Jose stops him?
I think because there's a good possibility because he will fight. He will fight. He's not going to do like a postal and just try to survive. Postal didn't fight to win, he fought to survive, so he survived. He's a survivor, that's been his whole career. He's a good fighter, but he's a survivor. Taylor will buy a guy who'll go out on a shield, you know? And that's what you have to do to win, to be an undisputed champion. You have to be willing to go out on your shelf. So.
Jose does that. Mike, you remember the guys behind you as kids?
Yeah. What is
this? This one
here. Bolis? Or toque?
Las bolis.
He's fighting. Las bolis? Pelao, you hear pelao. Amarre! Amarre! Amarre!
This is funny.
Letting their hands go.
What is it, like nine? What is watching that shit every night, reliving his prime. He relives his prime, Ellie.
Why not?
I told them I was like 17 years old. They trusted me working at ORTIZ and shit. They're stupid. I was like 17, Molly. I was like 18 right there working at ORTIZ.
Where was this fight?
That's
an Oxnard.
Oh, you only lost one time. Like that, other Molly's lost once. He was like 10-1.
Mikey, Crawford and Virgil, what do you think?
Is that something
they're talking about? Yes. Robert just told me he saw Crawford over the weekend.
Yeah, but we didn't talk about it.
You should have told him.
No.
Pita always tells him. Pita, Crawford and Virgil, what do you think?
Virgil.
What round?
7, 8.
Ninth round.
Ninth round.
What do you say, Robert?
Maybe Crawford runs to avoid getting stopped. Crawford will, when Crawford feels there's a threat. Yeah, if Virgil's fighting and he feels a little threatened, he feels a little dangerous, he'll run around.
Like breathing like that.
Like
breathing.
Por eso no se hacen las peleas, porque antes
del tiempo
ya estaban diciendo que engana.
¿Por qué no se
hace
nada? What's he saying, Robert?
That's why the fights don't happen. He says, they hear everybody saying he's gonna get knocked out, well, that's why he won't fight.
He'll fight. Crawford has balls. I don't think he's a great fighter. He's gonna want to prove himself.
Nah, Crawford's got it. Crawford will fight.
We'll see if he re-signs with them or not. It's coming. Mikey, you want to sign him to Garcia Promotions?
Who?
Terrence Crawford.
Yeah, I'll sign him.
I'll
help him.
You'll make more money, right?
You'll make more money.
Beef, probably making half of what he's making right now. More of that. Nope, twice.
Well, you have a lot of connections.
He'll make more money for sure. But he might actually be able to work out a good deal with them too.
That's true. You're right.
Yeah, because now that it's over.
It's over. He could actually
renegotiate like Canelo did with his own.
Yeah, he could do a really good deal.
I just found out that Hector Tanahar is a free agent.
Number one thing is not be greedy. Because if he gets greedy too, Top Rank can also walk away.
Don't out-price.
Which is not the worst case scenario. I mean, that might still allow Crawford to work with anybody else and still make a lot of money and make good fights and everything. But if you wanted to continue with Top Rank, right now is a good time to negotiate a good deal that's structured in his favor and, you know, in good faith. Everybody's happy.
I read an article from the Philippines where Manny Pacquiao told Top Rank, give me $40 million, give Crawford $10 million, and we'll do the fight.
I've been seeing that on the...
It's a real article.
Is it real?
I talked to people in the Philippines. It's a real respected reporter.
And did he really ask for that kind of money?
Yes, but I don't think they accommodated his request.
Oh. Then that means I ain't fighting him either.
Why?
He's going to ask that kind of money?
Damn, focus.
I haven't heard anything from him anyway.
Focus. Hello, in and out.
He's talking to the red one. It does the server test.
Is that Michael Jackson?
Just muffler for this.
Mikey, Burchell or Valdez, who you got?
Burchell.
Why? The scorpion. The scorpion. He is a beast.
He's strong, hungry. He's a beast right now.
He's a good dude, but so is Oscar.
Nah, I like Oscar because I know
Oscar
him.
Too.
I don't know about Chad.
I know Oscar too. He's a cool dude. I remember him from a few years back, from like 7 years ago or longer. But in this case,
what's up? Yeah,
you're asking for my opinion on that fight. Then I think
what's up, Mikey?
Better Chad.
How about Fury and Joshua? Robert told me before Joshua wins, and I agree with
Fury
him.
Fury and yes. Joshua?
If they fight. Bob Arum says they're very close. They're just a few minor things away from finishing the deal.
I pick Fury.
Why?
I believe in Fury. He's got the size that makes things complicated for other fighters. He's got the awkward, jerkiness style of fighting. You know, but he... Even though he looks to be a little, you know,
sloppy
and stuff, but he's still effective.
Yep.
He still is effective. He knows what he's doing in there. It may look like he's not properly balanced or you know stuff like that. It's not the traditional form of boxing, but like he'll pull back and do things that typically are not, you know, proper technique, but he does it. He's effective. So I actually picked Fury on that.
I'm thinking Joshua knows him. They're both familiar. Joshua is always in shape. Fury looks in a lot of shape right now. We'll see.
Yeah, they'll get in shape for the fight. It's not like they're fighting next week.
Fury did something. He ran into freezing water this week.
He ran through freezing water?
Yeah, like, you know, like they do the polar bear thing.
Oh, he did that? He saw him like that?
He ran in.
Oh.
How do you not get hypothermia? Robert, how do you run into like freezing water in the middle of the winter?
Well, that's, you know, because I'm sure he probably grew up like that too, you know. If you raise your kid to always, oh, don't go outside, put on your shoes because you're going to get sick. Don't step outside because you're going to get sick. All that bullshit, you know, then your kid's going to get sick. As soon as he fucking steps, you know, fucking even in the house, put on your shoes because you're going to get sick.
Who does that?
A lot of moms. A lot of moms do that shit, right? A lot of moms do that.
Overprotective.
They're too, yeah. Or you're gonna, don't go out without a jacket.
The main point, keep declaring the calzo fucking barefoot, and we get sick right away.
Psychologically. By the way, how's your new dog doing, Robert? Batman.
I'm good. My sister has him right now. My sister, Chela. She sent me a picture today. I'll try to show it to you right now. Sleeps a lot, but he's got a buddy right there. Look at him.
So at least they're cool. They're getting along.
Yeah, they're getting along. Cause it looks like I might be moving, so that's why he has him.
Why are you moving, Robert? Moving up in life?
Right here, no. I'm down. Actually, going down.
Downsizing the house.
Downsizing my house. But it's gonna be right around the corner from the gym.
So you can walk here.
Yeah, I can walk here.
My Mikey, you saw Mayweather called out 50 Cent, Logan Paul, and Jake Paul?
You'll beat them the same night. You'll beat all three the same night. That would be actually a cool event to watch, because three rounds each, you could beat all three on the same night. You'll beat the share of them all three. Same night. Yeah, he should do it. Like, see, fuck yeah.
That would break pay-per-view records.
One bite. One event each wouldn't probably do as great as all three on one night.
That'd be interesting. But life's good, Mikey. You're staying busy, just getting in shape right now.
Yeah, just starting to get in shape. So, I gotta get back in shape. Gotta lose some weight. Get me too fat, Ellie. Big Macs are too good.
Well,
if you... McDonald's slogan? I'm loving it.
Yeah.
Love
but
it.
It's not like you're gonna fight next week anyway, so.
No, but I do want to get in shape because I'm gonna be helping out. Jose.
Although he's fighting a southpaw.
Well, I'm gonna be fighting. I'm gonna be helping him. I'm gonna be a southpaw too. But I gotta be in shape, or else he's not gonna get good work out of me. You know?
Yeah, I'm looking
for me to get the best work. I gotta be in shape.
That's true.
And who knows? Maybe something comes up my way. Something comes. You know, some fight comes out. Out of that.
Boxing is always a lot of surprises, what people never expect, and it happens. And sometimes you shoot. I was sure certain fights happen, I already announced them and they don't happen. And sometimes you don't announce it and it happens, so. Canelo says he would knock out Charlo in five. Do you agree, Jamal Charlo?
I don't think he knocks him out in five. I think he does win, but I don't think he knocks him out. Maybe. I don't see it in five, maybe later.
I think there's more chance of it going there.
Yeah, I think so too. Charles good. Yeah, he's real good. I don't think he's knocking him out.
Have you got any calls from Eddie Hearn lately?
I messaged him, what was it, last week?
He's okay?
They're good.
You see Teofimo say if they don't pay him what he wants, he's taking his talents elsewhere?
I saw that on social media. But I don't know what the entire context, the whole conversation might have been like. So, I don't know, it's hard to say. But, I mean, I would assume he's still under contract. But it's going to be a little difficult for him to do so. If his contract says... there's a minimum of, say, $1 million per fight. And that's really all Top Rank is obligated to offer.
1.2 million, yeah.
You know, if the contract says $1 million and they're offering 1.2, he's already offering above his minimum. You know, try winning that in court.
Well, and it's going to purse bid. So what if another TV network picks it up? Which probably not. I think ESPN will have. He's going to fight his mandatory, Kambosos.
It is good on Teofimo's side to pressure and put a little, you know, put his foot down and actually, you know, demand something better. It is very good that he's doing that.
He got a great win.
Because if you don't, then they really do take advantage and walk right over you. Based on his last, you know, fight with Lomachenko, how big that fight was, and he won, and I mean, he should be making, you know, equal or more money.
I think Loma got 3.6 and he got 900 or 1 million.
It should be 1.2. Yeah, okay. But I mean, it should be more money, like. If it's
my 21st bid, huh?
Yes.
Eddie Hearn's gonna win that shit.
I would. I put it on the zone?
He's going for it.
Start bringing him
in. He's gonna bid on it.